I'll be performing the spoken word poem Complainers by Rudy Francisco. The following stories are true. May 26, 2003, Aaron Ralston was hiking. A boulder fell on his right hand. He waited 4 days and then amputated his arm using a pocket knife. On New Year's Eve, a woman was bungee jumping in Zimbabwe. The cord broke. She fell into a river and had to swim to land in crocodile-infested waters with a broken collarbone. Claire Champlin was smashed in the face by a 5-pound watermelon being propelled by a slingshot. Matthew Brobst was hit by a javelin. David Strigel was punched in the mouth by a kangaroo. The most amazing part of these stories is that when asked about the experiences, they all smiled, shrugged, and said, "I guess things could have been worse." So go ahead. Tell me that you're having a bad day. Tell me about the traffic. Tell me about your boss. Tell me about the job you've been trying to quit for the last 4 years. Tell me the morning is just a townhouse burning to the ground and the snooze button is a fire extinguisher. Tell me the alarm clock stole the keys to your smile, drove it into 7 a.m., and then the crash totaled your happiness. Tell me. Tell me. Tell me how blessed are we to have tragedy so small it can fit on the tips of our tongues. You see, when Evan lost his legs, he was speechless. When my cousin was assaulted, she didn't speak for 48 hours. When my uncle was murdered, we had to send out a search party to find my father's voice. Most people have no idea that tragedy and silence have the exact same address. When your day is a museum of disappointments hanging from events that were outside of your control, when you find yourself flailing in an ocean of, "Why is this happening to me?" When it feels like your guardian angel put in his 2-week notice 2 months ago and just decided not to tell you, when it feels like God is a babysitter that's always on the phone, when you get punched in the esophagus by a fistful of life, remember that every year, 2 million people die of dehydration, so it doesn't matter if the glass is half full or half empty, there's water in the cup. Drink it, and stop complaining. Muscle is created by repeatedly lifting things that have been designed to weigh us down. So when your shoulders feel heavy, stand up straight, lift your chin, call it exercise. When the world crumbles around you, you have to look at the wreckage and build a new one out of the pieces that are still here. Remember, you are still here. The human heart beats approximately 4,000 times per hour. Each pulse, each throb, each palpitation is a trophy engraved with the words, "You are still alive." You are still alive.